I love sitting on the wall of this brick well, looking out over my land. Every brick, it's laid with precision. I'd have it no other way. My father was Zadok Smith. He was a native Virginian who moved to Wilkes County, Georgia. He was a farmer too, but he decided that since I was named after a president of the United States of America, that I ought to follow in his footsteps. You know, even though I was the first honor graduate of that institution, I never could cotton to the law. A messy business, the law. I'd rather be out trading or peddling or working the soil. I served the Confederacy in that war of Yankee aggression, and soon thereafter, my partner and I were able to buy this place. On borrowed money, mind you. It was 1,000 acres of the sorriest soil you'd ever seen. But I was determined to turn that sorry dirt into good, rich farmland. So I studied, and I worked, and I tried all kinds of methods. And soon, I was rewarded with crops so big and plentiful, I could buy out my partner's share. You know, I found that the more I improved the land, the more crops I could grow. The more crops I could grow, the more money I could make. The more money I could make, the more land I could buy. Why, it wasn't long before the locals were saying that I wouldn't be satisfied until I owned all the land that was next to mine. And you know, I suppose that's about right. I turned this little bit of a farm into one of the largest farms in the state of Georgia. 20,000 acres, over 300 buildings, and thousands of farmhands. You know, I could ride all day long on a fast horse, mind you, and never leave my beautiful Smithonia. All I ever really had to buy was salt, tea, or coffee. People, they came from miles around just to study my farming methods. I guess you could say I was ahead of my time when it comes to farming. You give me a crop, and I can tell you the best way to grow it. Looking back, I guess I've devoted my entire life to building this farm. I suppose I could have found a wife. But you know, with all those farmhands, we needed houses and schools, a post office, a general store, a hotel, you know, not to mention the railroad that used the water from this very well that I was sitting on to operate those steam engines. And that railroad, it went to Colbert, went all the way to Winterville, and had short spurs all over Smithonia. Not a little railroad either. We had 2 locomotives, a passenger car, 7 boxcars, and 4 flat cars to carry my goods to market. Yes, I suppose you could say that I built everything on this farm, from a cottonseed mill, to a cotton gin, to a grist mill, a corn mill, a sawmill, a blacksmith shop, a brick-making factory, and over there a little further away from the house, that is, I even built something that's called a guano factory. Now, some of you might know that as natural fertilizer. Let me tell you, that guano, it can be a bit of a smelly business, but you just could not get the kind of crops that I wanted without good fertilizer. It takes good fertilizer to improve the soil. Then my house, you know, which was nothing special to begin with, it grew just like my crops. Before long, it was 10,000 square feet. You know, I built a well right in the middle of my house just so that I could have clean water. And that well, it was lined from top to bottom with bricks from my brick-making factory. And there's not a brick out of place either. I wouldn't stand for that. 8 feet in diameter and over 50 feet deep. Then finally, I had everything running smoothly around here, so I thought I'd try my hand at politics. You know, I ran for and I was elected to represent Oglethorpe County in the Georgia General Assembly from 1876 to 1881. I also served in the Georgia State Senate. Why, in 1906, I made a run at governor, but I was thwarted by a vicious opponent who made a big deal out of me using convict labor to run my farm. Hell, I never saw anything wrong with that. Those convicts, they should have been grateful to be able to work off their debt to society. I'm sick of politics these days, and I've got a feeling it's not going to get much better. You know, I produced over 2,000 bales of cotton on this farm every year. For those of you that aren't farmers, a bale of cotton weighs over 500 pounds. So you can figure I produced over 1,100,000 pounds of cotton a year from Smithonia. So y'all can say what you want to about me. There's a lot of stories out there. I think I took good care of my health. Every year, I put on the biggest picnic you can imagine with a spread so large. Why, I'll never forget the year we cooked 79 hogs and over 50 kettles of stew. My animals, some might tell you, I took better care of them than I did the prisoners. Maybe I knew every one of my mules by name. So yes, sir, I think that my works, they speak for me. I'm proud of Smithonia. I think I left Oglethorpe County and the state of Georgia with new farming methods, better ways of improving the soil, this beautiful farm that I call Smithonia, and a hell of a lot of good stories. That Confederate gold, I never saw it. All those stories you may hear about a bullwhip. Well, anyway, let's get over to that cotton over yonder. I got a new experiment I want to try. I've got a feeling that 1915, it might just be my best year ever.